Iconoclasts is very familiar at first view. It reminds you a bit of Metroid, of course, but it's slightly more story-driven, more action-driven. It's more like a story. A good comparison is the pacing of like a Resident Evil 4. Yeah. It's linear, but you can still go around a little bit. I tried my best to tell something that's really character-driven in a very interesting world, sort of like just a coming-of-age story in a science fiction setting. At BitSummit, I am really curious to see how much this game might appeal to this end of the world. After so much has inspired me from Japanese games in general, and just finally getting this game finished, seeing how people like it, and it's always fun to see how people react to it.
And this being the last one that you're on right now, what was the greatest thing you learned?
Don't do a giant game alone. It takes all of your time for 7 years now. So yeah, if you have a good, stable mind, you might be able to make it, but you might also go insane. I even do the music. Usually when people say, oh, you do everything, but you, who does the music? It's usually not included, so the game itself is finished, but there's still that marketing language and final assets phase. There's always bugs. They never end. I would really like some publisher to really understand what I want to go for and back me 100%, and just hopefully have faith in what I want to do in the future.